Hello, and welcome back.
I know you've heard stories about me. That I'm a liar. A manipulator.
Yeah, I've heard all that.
That I poison people's minds. Well, let me tell you.
You are short.
A true story.
You are a lot shorter than I thought you'd be.
Once was a young woman who had been ostracized by her community, bullied by friends, abused by her family. She took to a needle for help. She was all alone. She wanted to die. And she met the father. He gave her hope and confidence. The father showed her how special she was. She was full of love and life. He gave her a new family, one that accepted her just as she was. The young woman no longer wished to die. She had been given purpose.
How is all this happening? Like, how have I been drugged? I mean, I literally just saved the base. It's not like I've been captured.
The father brought her here. He asked if she had faith in him. He asked if she would be willing to die for him.
Those are not the kind of things a father should ask. You're gonna drop me.
And left. The father kept his word. The path to Eden is clear to those who have faith.
Hey, Marshall.
Walk the path.
Oh, creepy. Marshall, no! Get up here! I wanted to destroy this tower! Probably should've. Could've saved me all of this nonsense.
Let your faith be your guide. Leap. Accept the word of the Father into your heart.
Eh, I played Assassin's Creed. I think I can pull this off.
I will give you purpose. I will set you free.
Oh crap, I'm gonna hit. I'm gonna say that was very well orchestrated on her part. I mean, I'm assuming she has some way of influencing the vision. And maybe, like, you know, using certain phrases, she's able to guide certain images. Where am I? Oh, fuck! Oh my gosh, they just leapt to their deaths. How am I even alive?
That statue's one fat hunk of cement. You're gonna need heavy ammo to take it out, or something with a mounted gun that flies. You're smart, you'll figure it out.
How did I get here? And oh my gosh, it's just brutal. These people jump to their death. How the fuck did I even survive that? There's gotta be something nearby I can use to destroy this. Otherwise I might just have to look around and see if there's a different job to do for now. Okay, I think the hospital's still alive. Ugh, fuck. Okay, that just did not go well at all. Alright, clearly need something better than the bow and arrow for that. So that was one weird ordeal. Like getting that far and everything. Still, despite how creepy that speech was, it was clearly very well planned. Like, I'm not even talking just like the visualization, but I mean, like, you know, you paint the whole image of, like, you know, the tragic backstory, you know, finding hope and everything in a new place. And then also, like, you know, promising dreams of greatness and such. It's clever. I mean, did I ever escape? Or is this all just like some horrible illusion to make, to like break down my resistance? Like, is this all in my head? Is this basically Far Cry 3 all over again? Oh crap. Ugh.
Green
Whoa! Right, let's just... Ah, damn it. I was hoping he'd be spared. Shit. How the fuck am I gonna blow this up? Ugh.
Hey there.
Who the hell are you?
I ran into some junkie out by the rundown saloon. He tried to sell me some drugs that he promised would help fight the cold.
I still have no idea how I'm going to destroy this place. There's probably something around here. What the fuck is that? Well, I will be honest, I have absolutely no idea how I'm going to destroy this. Well, that did absolutely nothing. Alright, I give up. This will have to be left for another time. Admittedly, this hasn't been my best episode ever, but... I think I've done okay. Unfortunately, there were some interruptions off camera I had to deal with. Because I do this as a hobby. This isn't something that I'm obviously going to expend like a fortune into to produce. Right, I mean, I put a decent amount of money, I'd say, for like equipment and such, but I'm not going bankrupt over this. That's what happens when I try to parachute, apparently. Right, I'm going to get that outpost at least. That is my goal.
Yo, Ricky, that statue's one fat hunk of cement. You're gonna need heavy ammo to take it out. Or something with a mounted gun that flies. You're smart. You'll figure it out.
You know, I really feel I should have been given something to take it out. And I'm stuck going the exact opposite direction to where I need to go, so... Is there anything else I can do? Yeah, I suppose I'll just keep turning and try and go work around it. It's frustrating trying to get time to record. Because it's very tricky when you don't have your own independent living situation. Like, I mean, living with anyone else can throw a spanner into the works. Unfortunate, but there it is. Helicopter. Thank you. Oh, if only it was a helicopter with a gun on it. That would just make things so much easier. Pilgrimage. No, I just had a sudden realization. I've not parked up in ages. I don't think I'm going to do it now, but I think next episode I might. Alright. As long as I keep this velocity, I should be able to mark the rest of them out. Okay. Right. This is a good location. No. Come on. Oh gee, that was close. Nope. You're gonna bleed out, bitch. You're gonna be my bait. Some backup. It's been a while since I've had backup.
West side's got reinforcements coming in.
Fucking hell. Oh, maybe it was Grace. Why was it became Maggie? You know, I gotta admit, I really think this area is gonna be good for a flamethrower. Stop, you know, burning it.
Couldn't have done it with John Seed was a
right. I'm gonna up my ammo. Good. I'll change my weapons. Probably shouldn't have wasted money on that, but oh well. Oops. I'm not feeling that. Nah, I'm not feeling that either. I'm just gonna have a regular one. Ooh, Cyberfire, that sounds cool. Right. Now I think, before I continue, I'm just gonna get some, ooh, damn, I've got a lot of perk points. Right, so let's see. Alright, those are very generic. Let's see, this is the munitions, I think. That actually seems really useful, so I'm gonna get that. Oh, I get it, so these are different. Okay. I understand what I call now. That seems useful. Ooh. Ah, these would have actually been quite good. Ah, well, next time. Alright, just gonna finish off that corpse. Getting one last weapon filled. What should I go for? This looks good. Right, I'd say... Yeah, that's a good setup. Now, before we end, I just want to try out my new flamethrower.
Hey, you. Come here.
Shut up, lady. I don't quite understand why the burnt one still works. Alright, let's just see what this one is saying.
I could really use your help. Good job clearing the camp out. Of course, now we have another problem. We got ourselves one nasty cougar down past the river. It's not an ordinary beast. I heard it was from one of the cult's failed experiments.
Gross. It
kills anyone that gets close. Pumped it so full of the bliss drug, it'll make you hallucinate just being near it. I sent a team out to put it down, but they haven't come back. They're probably dead. I'd like you to finish the job. I gotta warn you, this critter is super dangerous and super unpredictable.
You sure do happily piggyback on everything we've done.
Hey, Jess. Hey, Jess.
Alright, on this note, I am actually going to end this episode now. It's hard to tell how long I've been doing this particular episode, due to some issues. But anyway, thank you for watching, I hope you've enjoyed. Please, like, actually, hold the phone, one last thing. Let's see if I can get a helicopter that has a gun. Well, I can't afford that. Typical, I can't afford any of the ones with guns. Wait, does that one have a gun? No, I don't think it does. No. Alright, I'm gonna end here. So, thank you for watching. I hope you've... Actually, no, I'm not gonna mess around. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. Please like and subscribe if you have, and have a great day. Goodbye.